In this video, we're going to talk about significant figures and rounding when we're doing addition and subtraction. Now, the idea is, so now you know what significant figures are. You know about how there's always some uncertainty in any number that you take from a measurement. Well, most of the time in chemistry and science, when we take a measurement, we just don't leave that number as it is, but we're going to manipulate it. We're going to do calculations with it to try to get some more information from it. And we want to keep the information about how good our measurement was as we carry out those calculations. So the tool that we're going to use, okay, is what we're talking about here in this one and the next video. So if the operations that we're doing are addition and subtraction, now it's important that you remember that you are aware of which operation you're doing, because it's a different rule when you're doing multiplication and division. We'll get to that in a bit. But anyway, if what you're doing is adding or subtracting, here we're going to look at the rule here. But first, okay, when we round, we just do simple rounding. That is, when we if our first number that we're going to drop, our first insignificant figure, is less than 5, then we just keep the last significant figure that we're going to keep as it is. If the first number that we're going to drop, that is our first insignificant figure, is greater than or equal to 5, then we're going to round up. For example, this number here, assuming it came from a measurement, 1.234999. Now, see these these subscripts right here? This is what I do. You should get used to it, and you should probably adopt that practice yourself. Is there are many times where you're going to want to keep track of at least your first one or two, maybe more, insignificant figures until you're finished with a set of operations. And so what I do is I want to keep information about which numbers are significant and which aren't. So I write my insignificant figures as subscripts. So in this number here, 1.234999, there's only really 3 significant figures. But for some reason, I had these other ones that I don't want to drop yet. So I wrote them as subscripts. But anyway, this number, because there are 3 significant figures in the first digit that I'm dropping, my first insignificant figure, it's less than 5. I'm just going to keep my last insignificant, my last significant figure, the last one I keep, as is. So I'd write this 1.23. Doesn't matter that all these are 999s out here. Don't do this recursively. In other words, don't round this up to 5 and then this up to 4. No. When you're rounding, all you do is you look at your first one you're dropping. If it's less than 5, keep it the same. Now, if it's 5 or bigger, then you round up. So in this number here, 1.23, 3 sig figs, my first insignificant figure is 5. 5 or bigger, I round up. So this I'd write as 1.24. Now here's the rule, okay? When you're adding or subtracting, when you're finished, what you're going to do is you're going to round your answer to the same place as the number that you're adding or subtracting, who has its last significant figure farthest to the left. What does that mean? Well, let's say we're adding these two numbers right here, 1.23 meters and 0.456 meters. Well, the last significant figure in 1.23 is the 3. That's in the hundredths place, or 2 places to the right of the decimal. The last significant figure in 0.456 is the 6. That's 3 to the right of the decimal, or the thousandths place. The 6 is farther to the right than the 3 is. The 3 is farther to the left. Got that? So that means we're going to round our answer to the same place as the 3 is in. That is 2 to the right of the decimal. So when we add these numbers together, we get 1.68, then sub 6. See, I wrote this 6 as a subscript because I saw that it's not going to be a significant figure, because I'm going to round to this place here. And then I round this to, because this is the first insignificant figure is 5 or greater, I round up, so I get 1.69 meters. Easy as that. Just remember to do it. Another example. Let's say we're subtracting. We measured 4,700 kilometers somehow, and we want to subtract out 20 kilometers. Now, okay, you tell me, where's the last significant figure in this number? It's a 7, right? Remember, if there's no decimal point, then trailing zeros do not count as significant figures. Remember that rule? And so the zeros in this case do not count because there's no decimal point. So the 7 in the 100s place is the last significant figure. Now in the 20, there is a decimal point. And so that means that the trailing zero does count as a significant figure, and it's in the 1s place. Well, comparing the 1s place to the 100s place, the 100s place is farther to the left than the 1s place. So when we get our answer, we're going to round to the hundredths place. So when we subtract 20 from this, we get 4,680. Again, the 80 zero is a subscript. And when we round, because 8 is 5 or bigger, we round up, we get 4,700 kilometers. Now, that's the same number we started with, right? All that means is that the number we're adding or subtracting from it is lost in the uncertainty in this number right here.